I have all the card stiffeners glued in place, and I've sealed the leather in between here with the glue. And then I bent this all back and forth and practiced folding it just to loosen everything up. And this piece has to come back around here and be attached to this strip. I have a 1/4 inch overlap here, and I've marked a line here. I know that this is the center, which would be here. I'm going to put a mark here and here, just for reference. So I'll put a little fish glue on here, just a little bit of fish glue on this part, and bring this around, line up that center line, push it down, and come along and work this together. And I'm going to do that off camera because I will be covered in fish glue, and I don't want fish glue on the camera. The problem with this double rise pneumatic, one section tends to inflate before the next, and these bellow sections will blow out. I had to add this binding tape to the sides to restrict the amount that that can open, and I limited that to about 90 degrees. Now the problem with this is it's so stiff that it won't collapse again, even under load. And if you put too much load on it, it doesn't have any power. I made the same thing. I used a little heavier material. Put the restrictions on this. This time it has a center board. That works pretty well. But again, it's so stiff, it won't collapse itself. And it doesn't seem to have much power. A couple of these worked reasonably well. This is a very thin lambskin material. It was unsealed and it would inflate. And then when you turn the air off, there's enough leak off out through the skin itself that it would collapse again. Using a small 1/8 inch hose, this inflated pretty slow and deflated fairly slow, actually too slow. This thing needs to inflate, deflate in 1 second, so a 1/2 second, 1 second. And I wanted it to be a smooth action. So that one, I tried some others with different weight of material. This is a heavier material. I tried one that was double acting, and this had an input on both sides. And it would go back and forth between the two. That was kind of interesting. Unfortunately, I didn't get that one on video. And then I made the same thing, trying different materials to seal the leather. And generally, it made it very stiff. And then I tried 3 of these using egg white to seal it. With a very thin lambskin, one that was a little bit thicker, and then the heaviest one. It's the same material I used on the bellows in the Senior 20. And that became stiff as a board. And that makes a very good spring. But it needs to collapse under its own weight like this one did. And these just won't do it. They're too stiff. They open themselves. By the time you get enough weight on here to collapse this, then this motor no longer has enough power to inflate itself. Using the puffs on this levered mechanism, that worked okay, but it's a bit jerky. And if you remember this one, it was jerky enough it would flip this right over on the other side. I've made quite a few of these. I've tried different materials for sealing the leather. I've tried the leather unsealed. And these double rise pneumatics. And I made quite a few puffs. I really want the movement on the conductor's arms and head to be very smooth. I haven't been too impressed with the movement of these so far. Some will work, but the movement is either too slow or too jerky. So I'm going to approach this from another direction.